So I was probably like, I want to say 26 or 27, and I had found a lump, and so I went to have it checked, and they did a biopsy, a lumpectomy at that time, and it was fine. Pretty young, and it was pretty scary, so I was like, oh, I don't want to do that again. So I didn't really start having regular mammograms like I was supposed to until they found this spot probably 2 years ago. They were just watching it, and it wasn't really growing, but the last one I went to, they said they found another spot, and it was pretty large considering the amount of time that I had been there before. He said to get a biopsy, so I had the biopsy done, and then that was on November 20th, and then 2 days later, they called me and told me that it was cancer. I actually was right below a stage one, so I didn't even hit a stage one. Yeah, so I was really fortunate.
Women should have a baseline mammogram between age 35 and 40 for the average risk individual, and that routine screening should be annual up until age 70. And then as long as your life expectancy is still 5 years or better, we still recommend that you get annual mammograms after age 70. Well, mammography has been probably the single most important technological advancement over the last several decades that has actually been shown to reduce the risk of breast cancer mortality. Can detect cancers when they are small, and 70% of women usually presented early with early stage breast cancer, and that when we do detect these small cancers, we have a much higher chance of curing the patient. The main thing that would increase your risk is having a positive family history. Now, most women don't have that, but those patients that do have high risk, if they've had breast cancer already, that would obviously put you at higher risk for second breast cancer than you would be if you hadn't had breast cancer. But those patients may be eligible for other screening methodologies, for example, MRI, particularly those with strong family histories. I personally think that's a very important thing that all women should do, is go through that genetic screening process.
When I went the last time, they said, oh, so we're watching two spots? And I said, no, just one spot. So then that's kind of when I knew something else had shown up and they had found something else. So they did an ultrasound and he told me right there that I needed to have a biopsy. And every time they'd do a mammogram and then they'd say, okay, we're gonna do an ultrasound. They just wanted to measure that other area to make sure that it hadn't been growing. I have dense breast tissue too.
Breast density is a combination of glandular tissue and fatty tissue. So the completely fatty replaced breast, the odds of being very confident in detecting cancer, probably 90-95%. Someone with extremely dense breast, somewhat like this, where this all this white tissue is glandular tissue, it would be very easy to miss a cancer in one of these breasts.
When we screen women with dense breasts, we frequently make recommendations that they perhaps should consider other imaging modalities, such as ultrasound, or if they do have an elevated risk of breast cancer, perhaps MRI as adjuncts to the mammogram. They don't replace mammogram because mammogram shows things that you can't see on ultrasound or MRI, such as calcifications, which may be an early sign of breast cancer, but these would be add-on tests that would increase the yield of breast cancer detection and also decrease the risk of having a breast cancer not having it detected on mammogram screening.